गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, ये जो लेक्चर की श्रृंखला है इसमें आज हम लोग बात करेंगे प्रकाश संश्लेषण की क्रिया की, जो कि बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट एक फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस है जो प्लांट्स में होता है। और ये इसलिए इम्पॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि इसके द्वारा प्रकाश जो सोलर एनर्जी है इसको प्लांट्स ट्रैप करके CO2 को फिक्स करके इसमें बायोमास बनाते हैं और इसके द्वारा प्रत्येक प्राणी को भोजन मिलता है। तो इसलिए ये क्रिया सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है। जो बेसिक फोटोसिंथेसिस है उसमें ये है कि ये केवल बड़े प्लांट्स ही नहीं बल्कि मॉसेज हैं, फर्न्स हैं, फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स हैं, एल्गीज हैं और इवन साइनोबैक्टीरिया है जिसमें भी क्लोरोप्लास्ट होता है या क्लोरोफिल होता है, वो सारे जो प्लांट्स हैं वो फोटोसिंथेसिस की क्रिया करते हैं और इसीलिए इनको ऑटोट्रॉप्स कहते हैं, जो कि अपना खाना खुद बनाते हैं। इसमें ये है कि सनलाइट इज नेसेसरी, जो कि सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी है, और ये दैट सोलर एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू केमिकल एनर्जी। ये एक बहुत ही शॉर्ट में आपको दिखाया गया है कि किस तरह से फोटोसिंथेसिस की क्रिया होती है। इसमें एक लीफ है जो कि ग्रीन कलर की है। ये लीफ जो है वो सनलाइट जो है रेडिएशन लेती है, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड को वातावरण से लेती है और वाटर एंड मिनरल्स जो हैं वो सॉइल से लेती है। तो इसमें कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, वाटर, सनलाइट एंड क्लोरोफिल, ये चीजें हैं जो मिलकर के कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स या सुगर्स बनाती हैं और वाटर बनाती हैं, ऑक्सीजन बनाती हैं। तो ये आउटपुट है और ये इनपुट है। ये एक शॉर्ट डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन है फोटोसिंथेसिस प्रोसेस का। ये दिस इज द रिएक्शन इन विच दिस CO2 प्लस 6H2O प्लस लाइट एनर्जी कन्वर्टेड इनटू C6H12O6 विच इज अ बेसिक मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ ग्लूकोज प्लस 6O2 द रिलीज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन। सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ दिस फोटोसिंथेसिस। व्हाई आर प्लांट्स ग्रीन? दिस ग्रीन कलर विच वी सी इन द नेचर इज ड्यू टू द कलर ऑफ द क्लोरोफिल पिगमेंट विच इज ग्रीन। सो इन प्लांट सेल, एक्चुअली प्लांट सेल में जो है वो क्लोरोप्लास्ट होता है जिसमें क्लोरोफिल होता है। ये क्लोरोप्लास्ट जो है ये ग्रीन कलर का है और ये जो थैलेकोइड मेम्ब्रेन है इसमें क्लोरोप्लास्ट इनपिगनेटेड होता है और इसमें जो फोटोसिंथेटिक पिगमेंट है जिसमें कि पर्टिकुलरली क्लोरोफिल्स हैं एंड कैरोटीनॉइड्स हैं, ये इसमें होते हैं और ये एक स्ट्रक्चर जो है वो क्लोरोप्लास्ट का दिखाया गया है, हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक। इसमें स्ट्रोमा होता है, ग्रेना जो थैलेकोइड है उसमें ग्रेनम होता है और ये इनर एंड आउटर मेम्ब्रेन्स जो है वो क्लोरोप्लास्ट की है। सो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द क्लोरोप्लास्ट विच इज फाउंड इनसाइड द सेल। ये जो कलर है, कलर ऑफ लाइट सीन इज द कलर नॉट एब्सॉर्ब, मीन्स ग्रीन कलर इज नॉट एब्सॉर्ब, रेस्ट ऑफ द कलर्स आर एब्सॉर्ब, सो इट लुक्स ग्रीन। सो देयर आर थ्री पोर्शंस, some light is absorbed, some light is reflected, some light is transmitted. So chloroplast absorb light energy and convert it into the chemical energy. This is the main function which the chloroplast does. This is again an overview of photosynthesis. What is happening? This is a leaf structure in which the carbon dioxide, the water in presence of light energy and carbon dioxide, this is converted into glucose plus oxygen gas. This is a simple form of simple representation of the entire photosynthetic process. This is an overview of light and light reaction and dark reaction also. So there are two reactions that takes place in photosynthesis. One is called light reaction, in which light is essential. Other is called dark reaction, where light is not required. In light reaction, actually in presence of sunlight, the photolysis of water takes place, and two products, one is ATP, which is an energy pocket or energy bundle, is formed, and the other is NADPH. So these are the two products which form in light reaction. And in dark reaction, this NADPH and ATP, they are used for fixing the carbon dioxide and conversion into carbohydrates. That dark reaction is also called the Calvin cycle or C3 cycle. And there are many products, the intermediate products that are formed in Calvin cycle. And finally, the sucrose or sugar molecule or the carbohydrate, they are synthesized. So in Calvin cycle, the sugar and carbon dioxide, sugar are formed from carbon dioxide, and ATP, which are generated in light reaction, provide the energy for sugar synthesis. The NADPH, which is produced as a result of light reaction by photolysis of water, that NADPH reacts with CO2 and reduce CO2, this carbon dioxide, into glucose. So this is the actual output of light and dark reactions. This is again a very, very simple representation of photosynthesis. Now, light reaction or the steps of photosynthesis, the light is the first and foremost thing where the chlorophyll absorbs light, then it vibrates and cause water to break apart, then oxygen is released into the air, then hydrogen remains in chloroplast attached to NADPH. The light reaction is over. Now there are two main outputs, one is oxygen and the another is NADP is converted into NADPH, which will finally used in dark reaction to reduce this carbon dioxide. So the step number two is the dark reaction, where which is called Calvin cycle also, where the CO2 from atmosphere is joined to hydrogen, form water molecules to form glucose. This glucose can be converted into other molecules with yummy flavors. There are so many other monosaccharides, disaccharides, trisaccharides, polysaccharides. There are many stages of carbohydrates. that are synthesized later on. So now this phenomena which occur in the plant, primarily in the leaves, and we can call it in the chloroplast. The chloroplast contain stroma, which is a fluid, and grana, which are the stacks of thylakoids. So thylakoids, they contain chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is a green pigment, which is ultimately capturing the light energy. So this is again the systematic representation and the structure of chloroplast. In the leaf, there are this palisade tissue, or we can call it mesophyll cells, where the chloroplast or is there, is present, and there are stomata occur in the ventral surface of the leaf, from where this gaseous exchange and water vapor exchange takes place. So this is the structure of chloroplast. Then you can see how the grana and the stroma look like, and how the chloroplast really looks like. So not only chlorophyll, but the chloroplast pigment contains several other pigments also, which gives different colors. So chlorophyll A is one, then chlorophyll B, which these two, chlorophyll A and B, are generally found in all higher plants. Then we have carotenoids, then we have xanthophylls. So these are the pigments that gives different color to the plants. You might have seen during different seasons that there are different colors in the plants that you observe in nature. This is the structure of chlorophyll A and B, and this CH3 is different in chlorophyll B. Otherwise, the rest of the structure is almost same. And in the center, there is magnesium. So this is the structure. And this porphyrin ring delocalized this E electron. So chlorophyll A has a methyl group. Chlorophyll B has a carbonyl group. This is the difference between these two. And this phyto tail, you can see how this chlorophyll looks like. Then these are the different peaks that absorb the light. Actually, in the spectrum, light spectrum, only in the visible wavelengths, the chlorophyll A and B, they absorb the sunlight. It's not that the entire light spectrum is absorbed. Only within visible light, you can see that the chlorophyll A and B, they absorb the light which is used for photosynthesis. So approximately, in nutshell, around 3 to 4, or at the most 5% of the radiation energy is captured and converted into the chemical energy. Not the entire energy or entire the photo energy is converted. No, only 3, 4 to 5 maximum. So now cyclic photophosphorylation. What is happening in the light reaction, you can see in photosynthetic bacteria, this reaction center is P700 nanometer, and how these photons from light, they come through photosystem first, and this primary electron acceptor, then it is ADP is converted into ATP in chemo osmosis, and this is the cycle which takes place in photosynthetic bacteria, and we call it photophosphorylation or cyclic photophosphorylation. This is the diagrammatic representation how this ATP mill generates ATP, how electron flows from the water splitting photosystem to NADP producing photosystem. So this is the diagrammatic representation through which you can very well understand the two type of photosystems cooperate in the light reaction. Photosystem first and photosystem second, and what are the different steps that followed in photosynthesis. Now this is the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, where non-cyclic means it is not coming back to its original place. Here you see the clear cut photosystem first and second, how this oxygen, this water is photolysis and converted into oxygen and 2H+. It releases two electrons that comes to P680, and this primary electron acceptor, it goes to primary electron acceptor, and then it moves through the electron transport chain and go to the photosystem first. Here energy for synthesis of ATP by chemoosmosis takes place, and then in photosystem second, P700 we call it, then the this primary electron acceptor again takes this two electron which are released, and these electrons they again move to different electron transport system and convert this NADP into NADPH, which is finally utilized in dark reaction. So there are cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation that takes place in light reaction. The net gain in light reaction is ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which is the energy bond, then NADPH and oxygen. This is the output of actually the light reaction. How the light reaction generate ATP and ADP, this you can see here. You might have seen in non-cyclic and cyclic and cyclic photophosphorylation also. So in electron transport system, ATP is generated, and in photosystem first, the NADP is produced. And where these electrons are working or what they are performing is can be seen in this diagrammatic representation. Now it is clear what is happening where. And this is again the diagrammatic representation where this this is the structure of thylakoid membrane, and this is the interior and the exterior membrane, and there is a stroma. So light reaction takes place in grana, the thylakoid membrane, and the H is released, hydrogen plus. This hydrogen ion and ion channel coupled to ATP synthesizing enzyme. So this is the again the diagram which explains how this light reaction takes place. This is the diagrammatic representation how this ATP by chemoosmosis in photosynthesis takes place, and what is the electron transport chain, how it is moving the electrons from one system to another system, and what are and how this NADP and ATP is formed. So the summary of the light dependent reaction is overall input is light energy and water, because water is a main source of oxygen and converting NADP into NADPH2. So these two are the important inputs. Others are light also and the chlorophyll, but these are the two main inputs, the light energy and the H2O. And the output is ATP, NADPH and O2, oxygen. This is the simplified dark reaction, or how this CO2 is reduced to PgA, and then this RUBP synthesis uses energy and 10G3P. So this is the Kelvin cycle or C3 cycle, how this CO2 is reduced to glucose. This is a simple way to explain the light dependent reaction or AKA Kelvin cycle. So this CO2 is converted into glucose in this process, and this ATP and NADPH drive the reduction of CO2 to C6H12O6, which is a basic molecule of glucose. So you can see in that cell how this CO2 is converted into glucose. So in Kelvin cycle, CO2 in net cell is added to 5 carbon sugar, which is RUBP or ribulose biphosphate, by the enzyme Rubisco. Rubisco enzyme are the photosynthetic enzymes, and they are responsible for converting this or reducing this CO2. This unstable 6 carbon compound splits into 2 molecules of PgA, phosphoglyceric acid. 3 phosphoglyceric acid is PgA. So this CO2 plus 5 carbon compound, they together form a unstable C6 carbon compound, which is again split into 2 PgA, 3 phosphoglyceric acid or 3 carbon compound. This 3 carbon compound is converted to glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate or G3P, we call it, 2 of which bond to form glucose. And these 3 phosphate glyceraldehyde, these 2 join together to form 1 molecule of glucose. So G3P is the 3 carbon sugar formed by 3 turns of the cycle. Now this is in nutshell the summary of the dark reaction is that overall input is carbon dioxide, ATP and NADPH, and overall output is glucose. So how and where this photosynthetic synthesis process goes in the chloroplast, and how the light and dark reactions they takes place, this is the summary, where the photosystem first and second they form ATP and NADPH, and in Kelvin cycle these 2 items they are used, and CO2 is reduced and converted to sugar. So and this sugar ultimately is used in cellular respiration for generating ATP energy molecules for running all the metabolic processes of the plants and animal. It also forms cellulose the cell wall made up of cellulose. So it is the basic material for construction of the cells in the plants. And starch is also formed, which we use as a food. Other organic compounds are also synthesized from the sugars, ultimately synthesized in photosynthesis. So this is just a summary of the photosynthesis. So one thing I would like to clear here is that the light reaction is generally a physical reaction. You can enhance the light reaction, but dark reaction has some limitations. You can't, it can't exceed more than a normal level of photosynthesis, because dark reaction is involved lot many rubiscos or photosynthetic enzymes, and synthesis of photosynthesis enzymes again takes time. They are governed by the genetics of the plant, so we just cannot enhance the rate of photosynthesis beyond a certain limit. That is the limitation. Now we have, based on the fixation of carbon at different level, we divide the plants into C3, C4 and CAM plants. In the C3, or we call the plants in which this C3 cycles take place, or first stable carbon compound is C3. Here rubisco grabs CO2, fixing it into carbohydrate in the light dependent reaction. This O2 can also react with rubisco, inhibiting its active side. Not good for glucose output, waste time and energy occupies this rubisco enzymes. So in photorespiration, sometimes the rubisco enzymes, they react with oxygen instead of CO2, and this occurs in the condition when intense light, high O2 concentration is there and high heat. So sometimes during the daytime or in summers, when the heat is very high and the O2 concentration is high, then photorespiration triggers, and that ultimately reduces the photosynthetic efficiency, because rubisco enzymes, they react with oxygen rather than CO2. So why high heat? When it is hot, plants close their stomata for conserving water, because water loss ultimately lead to the death of the plants because of the plasmolysis. So for adaptation, the plants, they close their stomata for water conservation. They continue to do photosynthesis, use up CO2 and produce O2. This O2, because there is no exchange of gases because of the closing of stomata, that creates high O2 concentration inside the plant cell, which ultimately lead to photorespiration, or trigger photorespiration. So in C3 plants, generally this light reaction and dark reaction and the Calvin cycle that takes place in normal way. In C4 synthesis, certain plants have developed the way to limit the amount of photorespiration, and there they have C4 pathways and CAM, castellation acid metabolism pathway, it takes place. Both convert CO2 into 4 carbon compounds which are intermediate. So these are called 4 carbon compounds, because in C3 plants the first stable carbon compound is C3, but in C4 it is C4 carbon compound, malate and aspartates, they are formed. So that's why they are called the C4 plants. And there is one additional quality in those plants, in C4 plants, that they have bundle sheath chloroplast also. So the CO2 is fixed at mesophyll cells, chloroplast, as well as the bundle sheath chloroplast. So that is the advantage in case of the C4 plants, where C4 cycle goes on. So in the C4, there are two places where the CO2 is fixed, and therefore they are C4, and in C4 plants, besides Calvin cycle, there is PEP carboxylase cycle also, or C4 cycle also, where we have the intermediate like C4 carbon compounds, malate and oxaloacetates. So these are the two compounds, they are also formed in C4 cycle. So in C4, the CO2 is fixed into 4 carbon intermediate, has an extra enzyme PEP carboxylase. So this is an extra enzyme, so besides normal enzymes which are found in Calvin cycle, and that is PEP carboxylase, that initiate to trap CO2 instead of Rubisco makes a 4 carbon intermediate. So this is the C3 pathway in Calvin cycle, and C4 is going with C3. So how does C4 pathway limit photorespiration? It does, because the bundle sheath cells are far from the surface, less O2 is in excess there. Next, the PEP carboxylase doesn't have an affinity for O2, allow plant to collect a lot of CO2 and concentrate it in the bundle sheath cell. So this is the advantage with C4 plant. The third category of plants is CAM pathways, which have the CAM pathway. They are mostly succulents, and they have they fix CO2, which releases in respiration during night, and store it in as a 4 carbon molecules in carbonic organic acids, and these organic acids they are again split to carbon dioxide and water, and this carbon dioxide is fixed in the daytime in Calvin cycle, because in these succulent plants they keep stomata closed during daytime to prevent water loss, and for that they require this CO2 for fixing or for to run the photosynthesis. So that CO2, which is fixed during night in form of carbonic acids, they are converted into, they release carbon dioxide and make the CO2 available to run the Calvin cycle. So this is the adaptation in the xeropetic plants, or mostly in succulent plants. So this is the another type of the mechanism of photosynthesis in plants. And here also the photorespiration effect is limited, and this collects CO2 at night so that it can be more concentrated during the day. Plants can still do the Calvin cycle during the day without losing water. So this is the adaptation, because they don't allow stomata to open to conserve water, and they use the same carbon dioxide which is released in during night in respiration. So the CAM, here in this slide you can see the pineapple and the sugarcane, which are, the pineapple is CAM plant, the sugarcane is C4, and these cycles are clear here how they are going on. Thank you so much.